But what we got to start understanding here, and I use as a topic of thought, is Jesus, I need your help. Jesus, I need your help. Oftentimes, amen, people begin to seek help in a lot of things, in a lot of places. They turn to drugs, alcohol, you name it. But that's not going to help you. It might make you feel good, amen, for a moment in time, but that's not going to help the root of the problem. Sometimes, amen, when we say, God, I need your help, meaning that I'm surrendering my will and every effort that I've tried to do to correct this thing and give it to you. Sister Kamika, amen, she had a beautiful testimony since she's been trying to do things, amen, her way of her own strength. But the realization is that you need help from God. But God, amen, he's a very present help in the time of need, amen. But we got to learn, amen, to depend on him. A lot of times, amen, just on this week, I had to go up into one of the labs and we was writing test procedures. And these procedures, amen, they, being the way that we do things, most of the steps that we need are already in our mind. Meaning the things that I have to do, I already know how to do it. But they got engineers, amen, that coming into it, amen, the government now, they don't have Navy experience, so they don't know how to do these things. So they want us to dumb these things down, so to speak. They want us to do a step-by-step, amen, procedure that somebody, that anybody, can walk up in there and push a few buttons and get the result. Even in that, amen, allowing somebody a step-by-step procedure, amen, you're still liable, amen, to miss something. Because what happened is, amen, that you're so focused, amen, that did I do the right step, this, that, and the other, you lost focus of what you're supposed to be doing. And so sometimes most of us, amen, we look at Microsoft and they got a help button. And if you click help, amen, they tell you how to do certain things, amen, within that program that you're trying to do. I was in a situation, amen, I couldn't help on one of these things. It says, not yet implemented. So I was listening for some help, amen, and the help that I needed wasn't there. But what we find here in this story, amen, the disciples, amen, he said, why are you talking to my disciples? Why are you questioning them? They said, listen, we brought, amen, this child to your disciples, and they was unable, praise be to God, to help him. They could not cast this devil out of him. And so sometimes, amen, people are going to question you, what's wrong with you, what's going on in your life. In other words, they're trying to render some assistance to you to try to help you to see what's going on in your life. But it's up to you, praise be to God, as a saint of God, to open up to them and say, this is the problem. This is what I'm going through. A lot of times we go to the doctor, they ask a series of questions so they can make the medical evaluation of what's going on based on what you say to them. The important thing my wife always told me, she said, Todd, you got to be open and honest with them, man. If you feel like a 10 today, tell them you feel like a 10, amen. And so it's the same way with God. Don't tell God you're okay knowing, amen, that all hell is breaking loose in your house. All hell is breaking loose on your job. All hell is breaking loose in your marriage. You got to learn to cry out to God and say, God, I need your help in this situation. This is what, amen, this father began to realize, amen. He said, the adversary, man, come trying to destroy this child. He said, how long has he been this way? How long has this thing came upon him? He said, since he was a child. And some of us have been going through some things for a mighty, mighty long time, amen. And we've been going through this thing and trying to figure it out on our own, amen. Seeking advice from here, there, and everywhere else, amen, but the word of God. But you need to cry out and say, Lord, I've sought this one and that one, amen, but I need your help. In other words, I'm going to stop, amen, my own will, and I'm going to surrender my will to you. I'm going to say, Lord, please help me. And sometimes our biggest hindrance, amen, from getting a blessing from God is our self-reliance on I can figure it out. I can do it on my own. But the word of God says, you cannot despise wise counsel. And what is he saying? If someone tell you need to seek the Lord in your situation, it's up to you to take that wise counsel and seek the Lord. Sometimes, amen, we can give people financial advice, but if they don't take the advice that you gave them, amen, the financial crisis is still there. If someone comes to me and says, what must I do to be saved? The word of God has already given me a step-by-step procedure to tell them, you need to repent, you need to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins. And you need to receive the precious gift of the Holy Ghost. That will never change, glory be to God. And therefore, we live in a changing society from one day to the next. This is in order, that's in order. This is in style, and that's in style. But glory be to God, the Word of God is always on time. He's always looking out for us because he's an eternal God. God knows, my God, the ending from the beginning, but we got to learn to trust him. We got to learn to say, Lord, I need your help. Sometimes, and I remember, praise be to God, when Microsoft first came out and everybody was in the PowerPoint. It was great, man. It was good, amen, but some people shied away from the computer. But those of us, amen, that dive down in it and start to work this thing, we became SMEs, systematic experts, amen. In other words, we became experts at what we knew how to do. So if somebody had a big presentation going, they'll say, hey, send it to Todd, amen. He knows PowerPoint. He can hook it up just how you want it. Just give it to him and he'll show you what to do. And so it with the Word of God, as saints of God, we're subject matter experts when it comes down to this Word of God. And those that are on the outside looking in, the world needs Jesus. Contrary to popular belief, they need the Word of God. And also those that are in the house of God, you still need the Word. The Word of God, saints of God, we're going to help us get through these last and evil days. We say you got to desire this Word more than your necessary food. But something begins to happen here. It happens, praise be to God, in verse number 22. He says, oftentimes it has cast him into the fire, into the waters to destroy him. Saints of God, some situation that happens in your life, they're not coming to take you out. But in this particular case, the adversary is trying to kill this child here. But some situation that saints of God, God is trying to get our attention and say, I'm trying to get your attention. Wake up, my God. I'm trying to get your attention. But we find here the adversary wants to destroy him. But listen what the Father says, but if thou can do anything, we know that we serve a God that can do anything but fail. God cannot lie and he cannot fail. So why sometimes are we struggling with the basic things? We settle the basic principles, my God, of saying, Lord, I need you. A child will cry out when he's wet. A child is going to cry out when he's hungry. A child is going to cry out when he's restless and can't sleep. And so do the saints of God. If there's a need that's in your life, you need to cry out to God. If you're hungry and thirsty for righteousness, you shall be filled according to the Word of God. He said, man should not live by bread alone, but every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. We know what the scripture says, but we got to make it applicable to our lives. We got to bring it in, my God. And we not only bring it in, but we got to hold it close to us. We got to hold it near and dear to our very soul. Because I know, amen, black folks down south talking about soul food. And it's a natural food that's good for the body. But you talking about some real soul food for the saints of God. This is it, my God. It's food for the women's soul. And sometimes they bless my Lord. Bless my soul, Lord. Come on and bless my soul. He's not trying to bless it through the Word of God. I'm trying to bless you through the saint of God that's sitting next to you, that's trying to give you the Word of God. Oh my God, sometimes we know what we need to do. Sometimes we know what we ought to be doing, but sometimes the enemy, amen, when he comes in like a flood, we stop doing those things that we know we need to be doing. Just on this morning, a little illustration, my God, Brother Lemire said, church, we need to pray, and so it is. Saints of God, we need to be praying one for another. It's a praying time for the house of God. Listen, as saints of God, we need to be worried about each other's first, and those on the outside become secondary. As a matter of fact, the Word of God says, let's especially be mindful of those of the household of faith. So what am I saying? You know how it is. Sometimes we say we're going to take care of our house first. This is a spiritual house. Let's take care of the house of God first. And I know how that might sound,
God. It might sound hard, but listen what I'm saying. The word of God says, he said, I came to the Jews first, the household of Israel, and they had to reject him so the Gentiles could make it in. But once the saints of God don't reject the word, receive it into your bosom and say, listen, this is the word of God. Because how do you know? Sometimes flesh, it does not want to abide by the word of God. As a matter of fact, it's contrary to the will of God. And so listen, he said, have compassion and help us. Listen what he says. He says, have some compassion and help us. How many need help on this morning? I need help, my God, in my life every single day. I need help when I get up in the morning. I'm getting a little up in age now, but I need some help, my God. But I thank God, while there's blood running warm in my veins, while I still have the strength of my voice, I'm going to praise God while I got a chance, while I still got a pep in my step, my God. I'm still going to give God a praise. Sometimes when we come to God's house, we got to lift up a praise and say, Lord, I'm going to praise you while I got a chance. Some things, say to God, we got to do it in our youth. Magnify the Lord in your youth. Magnify him in there where you got some strength. Magnify the Lord. As a matter of fact, the word of God says, listen, when you're young and not married, he said, that's the time you should be enjoying the Lord. Because once you hook up and get married, now your faith will come to your husband or to your wife. But glory be to God, while I'm single, I'm going to enjoy my singleness in the Lord. And now that I'm in the house of God, I'm going to enjoy this man called Jesus. I'm going to enjoy the saints of God. Yeah. I'm excited about what God can do for us. I'm excited because I begin to know and notice that the enemy of our soul, he is not, amen, stop his attack on us. Yeah. See, sometimes when you really sit back and pay attention to what the adversary is doing, see, I know what God is doing, but watch what the adversaries start doing as a result of what God is doing. Right. And see, sometimes that's what we fail to miss. We're so blessed and happy, but the enemy, amen, he's up the road, amen. He's trying to set a trap. If you're not careful, enjoying Jesus all the way, you're not watching, you're not praying, guess what's going to happen? You're going to find yourself caught in a snare and say, how did I get there? Sometimes, saints of God, this is what begins to happen. He begins to tell them, they say, listen, we brought him to your disciples. And he called them, the old faithless generation. See, sometimes, amen, it's our faith in God. You know, obviously, he talked about faith, amen, about grace. He said, faith, who? You got to have faith in who? In God, in Christ. And so sometimes saints, yeah, it's okay to put your faith in man. But what am I saying? I'm not talking about for salvation. I trust my wife every day. Glory be to God. She writes the check, pays the bill. Hallelujah. No doubt. I don't have to go behind her and check and tell the Lord, thank you. But what am I saying? I'm saying this. When it comes down to the word of God, you don't have to go back and check God. You need to go back and check yourself, my God. Don't check God. Watch what God do. And so therefore, begin to look at what the enemy is trying to do. As for the house of God, he's trying to bring all manner of sickness and diseases into the body of Christ. Remember what I said on one Tuesday night? I said, some of us have got to learn to step up. Mom Daisy right now is in the hospital. Yes, she is. Deacon Ellison, amen, is sick in his body. And so is Mother Ellison. And so as saints of God, at the end, begin to attack those, we got to step up and remind ourselves, let's pray. If it takes a conscious effort to lift them up before the name of Jesus, it takes a conscious effort to stop being so busy, glory be to God, and go by the hospital. It takes a conscious effort to take 5 minutes and start dialing that number and say, I'm just praying for you. I'm thinking about you. Glory be to God. Mom then said she was so happy that I stopped by. I said, listen here, it's no, hallelujah, it's no long journey for me. I'm right up in Fruitland. Glory be to God. It's my reasonable service. And so it is, saints of God, in these last and evil days, we need to start doing our reasonable service. We need to be about our Father's business. We need to make the phone calls and say, is there anything I can do for you while you're sick on today? Is there any from the house of God on today. If there's a need in your life, my God, you got to ask God, and God will supply your needs according to his riches and glory. He said, there's no good thing without holding them that will upright